It's time for another This Is Your Life on Sorrynation Street. And since they won't fund my bastard travel, I have to go on this horrible tram with the likes of Soft Lad here, Roy Cropper. Listen, shift that man bag. How far to Sorrynation Street? Well, if you get off at the next one, you can wade through the shit on the red wreck. Or alternatively, you can wait for two more and get off near the old brothel on Inkerman Street, and it's exactly 168 yards to the Rovers. There's still dog shit there, but not quite as bad. Ah, well, sounds about right. There is a new brothel opened up, actually, at the Peacock's residence. I beg your pardon. If you fancy taking in some company, my wife is, of course, practising. She's not quite experienced in street walking.
See you, Roy.
You'd have to be okay with her being half and half. She'll be inexpensive, with good reason. Well, now I've got out of that horror situation. We're here to speak to a very special woman, one who was put up with her husband's appalling flatulence since the start of the 80s. Now I'm here, thanks to Cropper. Let's see what the old mare is up to in the Rovers before we shock her.
I don't see why you have to blame Ina Sharples for having an arse like Chernobyl, as frightening as she was.
She was a tyrant.
Yes, I think if you'd been there, you were too busy sucking off Langton in the brickyard. I've more than had enough of you not knowing a fucking thing about my intestinal devastation. Another drink?
Yeah, stick an ouzo in it.
Or perhaps you prefer an Uzi, as you're about to be humiliated. Deirdre Langarlo Sheed, this is your life.
Well, I don't mind. This is better than fucking about in here.
Tell Ken to drink that shit himself because we're off to the big studio for a laugh.
Yeah, whatever. I'm up for out, you know that. Well, you should.
Good. Well, let's get a move on,
eh? Absolute joke,
this. Shut up, Ken, or you won't be invited.
We could do with the fresh air, to be honest.
Everyone just shut the fuck up. I'm glad you've ditched the glasses. I thought I'd accosted Sue Pollard on first glance. We know you've had a long-suffering, underachieving existence on Sorrynation Street, as most do. Now we're going to go back in time and show some of your exploits and hope along the way it emphasises what a waste of time it's all been. Deirdre Hunt, Langton, Barlow, Rashid, have a look at this.
That nappy changing will come in handy.
Oh, not now, mother, fuck's sake.
You're a fucking mug.
Just checking, there's free food after.
Yes,
only
well.
My stand's a fat cunt.
Oh, we know. Tell me I'm right.
Just because I broke wind at your family Christmas, you suddenly want a divorce.
You destroyed the atmosphere. We had to eat outside because of you.
Here's the rest of Sorrynation Street on another freebie.
Hiya, Chalk.
Here, have some of this.
Jack, that turns me on.
All right, Deirdre.
Oh, there's the antidote. Oh, it's me guilty pleasure.
I'm in the Radisson, room 412. Bring your specs.
Oh, me favourite pensioner.
I'm better than fucking Blanche.
Are you Tracy's stunt double? Where are your parents?
Hello, Deirdre.
Hey, you fellas on the bus trying to pimp you out.
I know, I'll kill him, don't worry.
Oh, please don't do loose women.
Oh, bless.
Hey, now.
Oh, Curly, what's it?
It's what's all right. Hey, you.
You're not bad for someone with no lips. Sort your son out.
All right, Deirdre.
Hey, how's your dad?
He's Irish as fuck.
Brilliant. Shit studio, this. Better than this morning. I'm no Schofield. Oh, there you are.
You're looking better than our Elizabeth Sawyer.
Oh, cheers for slapping Sally one. What's with the Rita hairdo?
Oh, it's a wig. I were too stoned to style it.
Now then, sweetheart.
Oh, bless your little round head.
Cheeky bitch.
Oh, you made it then.
I like trams. What can I say?
All right, how many do you want?
Now then, our lass.
Oh, this is the best bit. Alfie. Oh. Fucking hell. Tell your Audrey to get her shit together.
I've more chance of making the millennium. Well, good to see Roy could stop shagging the trams to come tonight. Alf Roberts, you're well over with this crowd. Why did you give Deirdre a job in your shop?
Well, she had big glasses and people liked to come in and have a laugh. Also, I felt sorry for her. She had a moose of a mother and Ken shitting all over. Audrey was always bombed, so it was nice for both of us, really.
We did nout.
Bloody right we didn't. So, yeah, Jesus, give me some credit. So she did a good job and I sold a lot of spam in that time, funnily enough.
It's all I could recommend at that bloody place.
War rations.
Yes, well, it's not a fucking Waitrose, love. You prefer stuffed marrow, don't you? Now, we'll get a bit seedier because it's time to bring out a right mutton, but she's dressed as lamb as per usual. Sorry, Jim and Steve, but it's Liz McDonald.
Oh. Oh, come here, you old tart. Oh.
Now, Liz, you used to have daft curly hair like Deirdre, didn't you?
I did. I thought it was style, but I looked a proper knobhead. Thankfully, we're a bit classier now. Though I'm probably looking at becoming a Poundland Diana Dawes in the next few years. This one, however, she's a triumph. I don't know how she manages each day. And she drinks like a bloody fish.
Oh, I do, I do.
Imagine living in the house with all that nonsense going on and still having the strength not to slay them all with an axe and bury them in the yard. Proper woman, this one.
That's enough of that, pair of lesbians. Right, now here's another guest.
She's a star in my eyes.
It's Matthew Kelly.
Ah.
Matthew, what are you doing here?
Well, what it is, Michael, is I had nout to do, if I'm honest with you. And I once nobbed Deirdre during a theatre production gala in the Midlands, and I will say that when I watch her on Sorrynation Street, it gives me a right royal rock on, and even though she struggles and smokes like a cruise liner, she'll make you feel better about yourself. And you know me, I work with some right mongs on Stars in Your Eyes, so I often feel bloody depressed.
Oh, yes, it's shit.
So that's why I wanted to pay me respects, really. Not that you're dead or anything. I watch her in number one on Sorry, and I think to myself, mediocre I may be, but I'm not one of the Deirdre Barlows of life, and that's the best way to beat the demons. Is to appreciate she takes one for the team every day.
Oh, thank you so much. Bit passive-aggressive, though.
Oh, don't mention it. I'm not fucking bothered.
Now, let's get down to things that matter. You made your Sorrynation Street debut a fair while back when you looked somewhat of a palatable woman, before your voice descended into that noise the washing machine makes when it drains itself. Here's the first time you were seen.
You know what we need? Hookers.
Oh, I'm game for that, aye. Are you one, love?
No, but my mother is, as it happens.
Oh, we know about Blanche, but we've heard you're keen.
I'm keen if you've a few quid. I don't suppose Elsie lets you get away without...
Oh, shut up, you daft bitch. Here, let's get some more ale in.
Fuck me, I don't know what's wrong with that street. Now, Deirdre, you pissed about for a few years, drinking and banging around and trying to kill Tracy Love with timber lorries until 1983, when you decided to receive a daily pork enema from Mike Baldwin. And here, I'm sorry to say, is the boring corner of that triangle, Kenneth Barlow. Hello, Deirdre. I couldn't be arsed travelling down. I just came straight home to the dog. I've noticed once again, they broadcast your This Is Your Life and mine's locked in storage. Too racy, I suppose, for even you lot. I'm glad I'm not there anyway, because my arse is playing up again. I've had to eat a bowl of all bran to bung up the flow. Now, I could say something nice, but you did let Baldwin knob you, and I haven't forgotten that. I also don't like that crowd out there. You sound like a real shower of unfortunates. Good I'm not there. I think I'd only end up being humiliated again, and even with Curly Watts in the building. So fuck This Is Your Life. And Michael Aspel can ram that book up his canyon. That, I can assure you, was the dog. I'm sticking this to Barlow. Here's Baldwin himself! Mike, don't be poking her here.
Oh, don't worry about that. She's a bit old for me now. I remember thinking, at least if I get in on this now, Barlow's shitting will get worse, and he'll be in the carsy too long to notice me buffing his daughter Susan.
Oh, I think he knows by now.
It was those glasses, I'll tell you. Reminded me of a prospectless secretary. You can't get kinkier than that.
Now remember when you went to jail, Deirdre? Before Sorrynation Street legalised all crime bar murder, you got stitched up for fraud. Something that got the nation so upset, they started to all become raging activists. Back when soaps were strong and not ghetto pantomime, and people actually gave a shit, even the Prime Minister stopped causing trouble to throw his two penneth in. And here to bring some fucking dreadful memories back are John Lindsay, Billy Walker, and teenage Tracy Love Barlow. John Lindsay, no bigger cunt hath there been.
Yeah, but I wasn't going to fucking jail, was I?
Oh, you're a grade A bellend, aren't you, love?
And Billy, you almost became part of the surname list for Deirdre here.
Well, her mother threatened to have me shot, so I realised it wasn't worth it. I'd been throwing seed at every bird on the street. Bit like Ken before his colon. And Deirdre was different because she made a brew after, and I thought, I could get used to that. And she makes a proper effort.
Tracy Love, how have you dealt with the transition to CDs?
Yeah, it's been shit. I can't record fuck all with them when charts are on. But we're here for Mam and she's put up with a lot from me. Trying to blow her house up with chip pan and chucking ease down my neck. She's alright, really.
Oh, you're so scatty.
Now let's watch where all the carnage started. When you married Ray Langton.
Now Raymond, take this brass tap washer and place it over the same finger Deirdre put up you last night. Now tell her you're not taking a piss with all this.
I'm not taking a piss at all, Deirdre.
Tell her she's tidy.
Aye, well, you are a bit tidy, no joke.
Well, Ray Langton went off to get Audrey out in Holland after you fucked him off, and we decided to go out there and bring him back at gunpoint. He looks more like Bilbo Baggins nowadays, but he's here whether he likes it or not. It's Quick Lay Ray Langton.
He's here.
Ray, what do you reckon now?
Well, she's still a tart, aren't you, love?
I'm a cougar now, you know.
That's open to opinion. Listen, I was high every day over in Amsterdam since I left. I've also been nicking jewellery as a side hobby, and I wear this one every day now.
Fuck me, you didn't change, did you?
Now, it's special because it says on it, ALYNK. A-L-Y-N-K. Yes. And would you like to know what it stands for?
Spit it out, for fuck's sake.
It stands for at least you're not Ken.
Well, you're right. You got out before it went to shit, whereas Ken's been stuck with Mother, who fucking hated Ray, let's be fair. I remember, she used to slap you every time she saw you. Because, as you know, she's a miserable old bitch. But Ken gets it now. And you get to smoke weed and bang upgraded prozzies again, you lucky twat.
Well, despite that being true, we had a right laugh, and I do pop big specks on the Dutch oars sometimes as a tribute to you.
Oh, Ray.
Sometimes make them smoke 8 ciggies before they get the gob round it.
You're a diamond.
Bless you, kid.
Well, I'm gagging for a piss and a pint, so Deirdre Barlow, this is your life.
How about it then, eh?
I'm on a promise from Alma, aren't I?
Oh, well, I'll get in on that.
Oh.